Hey, how's it going, YouTube? I'm your host for today, Landon Do Not Sing, and welcome back to another Most Amazing Top 10 video. Before we get started, I want to know, what was your favorite thing in high school? Let me know in the comment section below. Mine is math or gym class or recess. Was it even called recess in high school? I feel like it wasn't. Also, make sure you guys hit the like button if you guys went to high school. So hopefully everyone's hitting the like button. Every year in high school, they give us a yearbook so we can look back and reminisce about the good times. We are forced to take awkwardly posed photos so that our parents can spend $50 on those pictures that will probably end up in a dust frame or in a box stored in the attic. But sometimes it is funny to look back at these pictures in the yearbook because you might stumble across some pretty hilarious or frightening pictures. So prepare yourself for this one as we give you the top 10 scary yearbook photos. Let's get things started with Justin Bieber. I mean, is no one freaked out by the Biebs? Is it just me? Okay, all jokes aside, let's actually get started on this list. Biebs not on this. Number 10, we have the 80s that have been haunting us. No, seriously, the 80s called and they want their massive hair back. How long did it take her to style this? She must have spent a week preparing for her yearbook photo. And she probably went through 3 different types of mousse and hairspray bottles. I just don't get it. Her bangs are taller than the Empire State Building. It's scary how much style has changed over the years. But maybe this hairstyle will come back in style. I hope it doesn't in my lifetime, but maybe it will someday. Also, you never know what's hiding in that thing. There must have been some several birds in that thing, maybe, because they probably think it's a nest. I mean, they would save a lot of time because they wouldn't need to gather any materials. I wonder if this girl is still rocking this hairstyle today. From one bad hairstyle to another one, at number 9, meet Mr. Savvy. Okay, no, seriously, take a look at him. His mullet is so neatly preserved. He's got a nice little poof happening on top of his head and a little bit of frizz on the length. And he also has the Post Malone mustache going on. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you guys know what I'm talking about. It looks like two dogs greeting each other. Even though the mullet still exists today, that's not what is scaring me. It's the look in his eyes. He looks like he absolutely hates the whole high school experience and he just can't wait to get out into the real world. It looks like he might have even had a job interview after this photo was taken. I hope he got the job. Number 8 takes us to the kid who is experiencing a lot of pain. No, seriously, why is he so upset here? Does no one care? This photographer has no heart. And the photographer was just like, you can cry, but just sit still because we gotta take this picture. I just don't want you like blurry. Place your hands on your lap, twist your body in this awkward position, and show some teeth. And then he took this picture and then bam, in the yearbook. But seriously, why are yearbook photos so awkward and uncomfortable? I wish we can just submit our own pictures, like get ready in our own time, take a nice picture of us, get that nice angle going on, and submit that to the school. And then this is what I want in the yearbook. Well, this kid definitely had to go to the yearbook photo retake day. And I'm pretty sure that is a day. It's like you see your photo, it's like, oh my God, what was I thinking? You do the retake, but then again, and then you hate that one as well. So this is probably the retake day picture. And did he see a ghost? Was he bullied right before this picture was taken? Because I feel pretty bad. Or did he have to sneeze? I guess we'll never know the right answer. But what do you guys think happened here? Let me know in the comment section below. Up next, at number 7, we have another unfortunate hairstyle. It's actually really scary to see what young people are capable of. Did he lose a bet or was this a dare? Either way, his parents aren't gonna buy this picture. And like, how long did it take him to achieve this look? He must have had 4 little sprouts on top of his head for a couple of years. So maybe his parents haven't purchased any yearbooks for his entire time in high school. And what's with the little elastics on the ponytail? I'm not really sure what's going on in his mind. He must have been flunking all of his other classes too. Okay, whoa. In at number 6, we have the real life werewolf. Don't believe me? Well, take a look at this picture for yourselves. He looks like a type of guy who would be standing over you, eating a turkey leg and watching you sleep. There's just something about his eyes that is making me feel uneasy. Also, he looks really old to be in high school. He looks like he must have had 2 divorced wives, 3 bald cats living at home as well. Why? I don't know. I thought I'd add that in there. Why is he at high school taking a yearbook photo? I think everyone has a really old person in their grade who can't pass at least one of the classes because they want to be in high school forever. But then sometimes teachers just feel guilty for them and just pass them out of pity. Well, he's giving me the creep, so let's move on. Number 5. Now, we have a real life vampire. Okay, this vampire guy is definitely more scary than the werewolf guy. He looks like he just drank the blood of his victim and he was running late for his yearbook photo, so he didn't even bother to wipe his mouth. And what's up with those black tears coming out of his eyes? Did he audition for Twilight? I've never seen any of those movies. Are they good? Everyone's talking about it. I feel like he might have been at home performing some satanic or ritual on a pig that he stole from a nearby field. So before he sends a curse my way, Let's move on. And if I said anything bad about you, buddy, I'm sorry. Don't come find me. The creepy old man slides onto this list in at number 4. Take a look at his picture. It looks like he's trying to steal her soul. And look, he is the math chairman. Why is always the math teacher the creepy one? No, seriously, it's like a prerequisite to become a math teacher. And how old is he? He should have retired twice by now. If that was a Spanish teacher, I would hand in my resignation letter and never visit the math department again. Or maybe this was the photographer's fault and he didn't want to wait for him to sit down. So he took the picture and told the math chairman that it's a good look and to, get back in your coffin. I mean classroom now. Okay, in at number 3 will make you have nightmares. Take a look at this creepy yearbook photo. I can't handle this right now. I think I have just way too many questions about this. I have so many questions about his decision-making skills and this picture. Like, why did he come to school covered in white paint with tears down his face? Who led him into school looking like this? Why doesn't he have a shirt on? I mean, there's so many questions. Why is there a ball patch on his head? Like, did he run out of paint? And why is he pointing at me? I don't feel good about this scary one, so I'm gonna try to erase this from my memory, and I'm sorry to share it with you guys. Number 2 takes us over to El Paso High School. The high school was first built in 1916, so it has a long creepy history, and the school is considered to be the most haunted building in El Paso, Texas. One of the most creepy stories about this high school involves a student yearbook. It is put on display at the front of the school, and it is open to a page that shows a picture of a graduating class of 1985. All of the students and teachers in this picture are in focus except for one girl who is wearing a white dress. She is actually pretty blurry and fuzzy. This girl is not part of the graduating class, and no one has been able to recognize her. Her figure does not appear in the original negative of this picture, so a lot of people are actually saying that she is a ghost, and I'm here to confirm it. She's a ghost. Okay, finally, number 1 spot, we have this gem. Guys, I don't even know where to begin with this one. I kind of need your help. I don't know if this was just a bad print job or if he's an actual alien. Either way, I wouldn't want this to be in my yearbook. It's actually pretty terrifying. It says this picture was taken in the 1950s, so maybe he was a victim of an unethical or inhumane human experiment. Or maybe he's a ghost with a distorted face who haunts those who looks into his eyes. So you guys gotta stop looking into them. Alright guys, well thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you guys all in the next Most Amazing Top 10 video.